My name is Chelsea. I'm one of the behaviour trainers here at the Animal Welfare League of New South Wales. This is Dallas, a six-month-old kid who is available for adoption here. As you can see, cats can be pretty endlessly entertaining when they play, but it is important to remember that they're a predator species as well as a prey species, so lots of their play activity actually resembles hunting activity. So there's a few do's and don'ts to remember when playing with cats so we ensure that the play is satisfying for the cat and also it keeps us safe. So the first don't is we never want to use our hands, feet or items of clothing to play with the cat or to entice them to play because often that leads to undesirable behaviours like biting and scratching of our hands or chasing us down the hallway to grab the hem of our pants or skirt. It's also important to remember not to touch your cat's body during play, so they can get quite hyper aroused, and obviously when they're hunting it's not very usual for them to have somebody come over and pat them. So for a cat to be patted during play, you'll often also be reinforcing them grabbing hold of you with their claws or biting your hands or feet. So some of the do's of play, we want to make sure that cat play is really satisfying for the cat. We think about their normal hunting activity, we remember that they do lots of watching of prey, they might stalk and then they'll pounce and catch the prey item, which in this case is a toy. So we don't want to tease the cat. If we're sitting here and we're wriggling the toy around for a few minutes and we find that the cat's just kind of sitting somewhere and watching us, it doesn't necessarily mean that they're not engaged with the play, it just means that they're still in that part of the hunting activity where they're watching and getting ready to pounce. So we want to make sure that we keep playing until we find that they are either really disinterested or walk away, or they catch the prey and they stop playing. So the last thing to think about with play is how to end a play session. So we want to keep playing with the cat until they're tired or they disengage. So if they look like they're getting really exhausted, they, you know, they're taking breaks, they might be panting a little bit, we can stop. Or if they disengage themselves and they walk away, you know, they do something else, they go and get a drink or whatever it might be, we can stop the session. For cats like Dallas, you can see that he can get quite hyper aroused with play and he may not stop because he's just too excited by the play, he wants to keep going. So we might need to wind him down by offering him a toy that's less enticing, so something that might be stationary like this, unless he pokes it around himself, and we can give him some treats as well to trade out the toy.